Assalamu alaikum friends. First we have to open a assembly window. Then we have to insert a support plate for a gear. Go to the design library and select a spur gear from design tools. Then we have to make the gear with support plate. Before that we can specify the number of teeth and module for the spur gear. Then click OK. Then assemble the spur gear into support plate. Just select a cylindrical surface and make a concentric mate. Then select a flat face to coincident mate. Then click OK. We have to increase the diameter of the shaft in support plate, which can be compatible with spur gear. Then we have to insert a worm gear. In dialog box we can specify the module and number of teeth and nomenclature for the worm gear as per our requirement. Then we have to move the worm gear according to the position of spur gear. Make a coincident mate and click OK. Rotate the worm gear. Move the worm gear to bottom of the spur gear. Then place the worm gear at correct position, which have the proper merging of gear teeth. Edit the module of worm gear and spur gear as per the merging region. Now we have to achieve the correct position of spur and worm gear. Then go to the mate and use a distance mate between the worm gear and supporting plate for arresting the vertical movement of worm gear. Then go to the mechanical mates and select a rack and pinion. Make it to the normal view. After selecting a rack and pinion mate, first we have to select the edge of the rack like worm gear. Then in pinion gear, we have to just go to the design tree and select a spur gear. Here we have to select a tooth cut. Right click on that and show the pitch circles of the tooth cut. Select the hidden lines of pitch circles in pinion gear tab. Now the worm gear mate is successfully applied. You just drag any of the gear to show the movement and mechanism. To get the regular updates on my video, please subscribe in my channel. Don't forget to like and share. Inshallah, we will meet in the next video. Thanks for watching.